is everyone. Well, let's get caught up on some things and kind of see what's going on with us. So obviously, since we've talked last, went up on the road to St. Joe Central Friday night. Played really well up there, maybe as well as we've played offensively. In a while, we were over 1.2 points per possession. Ball was really moving. Hit 10 threes in large part because we took great ones all night. So we were able to get Central at their place and then came back last night in a battle of first and second place in conference, us and Park Hill South. And Park Hill South got all over us. Credit to them. They were terrific. They were really, really good last night. They made us look bad. We didn't play bad. On our own doing, we played bad because of the opponent. And sometimes when you play at a high level, that happens. And so I don't want to overreact to our guys or discredit Park Hill South. They were that good, and they took us out of what we wanted to do. So now, two losses in conference, 4-2, puts us a game back of the league. But obviously, we go over on Friday night now. And we'll see Liberty in what'll be a really good matchup. Anticipate a really good crowd, a lot of excitement around it for certain. I know our guys are excited, especially coming off a loss, to be able to get back out and play in that kind of environment. Our crowd's always influential in it, and I know they will be Friday night. We're certainly looking forward to that.
So focusing in on Robbie Hansen, he has made 59 three-pointers in his career. So how is he planning to come out strong, seeing that he and the rest of the team struggled in the first half in the first game against Liberty?
Yeah, I think that we'll use the experience or the game as information to improve what we need to do. Robbie specifically, the way that they guard him, the way that they take things away from him, has been just an evolution throughout the year as the scouting report's gone out, as well as he's playing. I think that now he's made some adjustment, we've made some adjustments around, but we'll take all of what happened against Liberty the first time, both good and bad, process it, get it into a report for our guys so they know what to do different.
We know from watching the team that when you're on a roll, the team improves by building off that energy. If the team is unable to get in that mode of the success, how is your team planning to now cope with that?
Ask that again.
We know from watching the team that when you're on a roll, the team improves by building off that energy. If the team is unable to get in this mode of success, how is your team planning to cope with that?
So you create some momentum, some positive energy by the plays you make. So if we're able to make good plays, that'll create some of our energy. The challenge is when things aren't going well, where does your energy come from and where do you create it? So your question's really good. I don't have a magic answer for it, but I hope that the experience over the last couple of games where maybe that has been the case, we're able to use to benefit us now that when we get in those situations again.
How do you use the depth on the bench to your advantage?
Yeah, and I think that that's been an evolution as far as our depth goes. Played a lot of guys early, 9-10 guys early, trying to figure out strengths and roles. We look at, a bunch of statistics and analysis as far as lineup analysis goes. We've got information that shows when certain lineups are on the floor, what their plus minus is, how many minutes groups have played together, what their defensive rebounding percentage is together. So you take all the information and data to try to formulate and compare it with what you see on the tape and on the floor and who plays well together and accentuate each other's strengths. But we're using our depth to put guys in situations where they can play to their strengths and play well. So finding the right lineup combinations is really important to that.
Coming off a difficult loss against Park Hill South last night, how are you preparing a coaching perspective now to change better challenge Liberty just a couple of days from now?
Yeah. We've got a little saying in our program that, Friday night's the biggest game of our year because it's our next game. And we treat them that way for a reason, because if you don't, then all of a sudden games have different magnitude to them, different level to them that can freak guys out and make them play goofy. So just like we thought when we were going up to play them, or when they were coming in to play us, and now when we're going over to play them, it's a big game because it's our next game and our next opportunity. So, you know, we wouldn't be too high if we were able to beat South. We lost to South. We're not going to be too low, and we'll just have a heck of a battle Friday night.
Your relationship with Coach Sturtz goes way back. You coached with him for a number of years over at Liberty.
Yeah.
And he had this to say about your relationship. I coach here and he coaches there. We are both just trying to win games. That's just the honesty of it. That doesn't change the respect and admiration I have for him and his family. We actually talk more about family than we do about basketball. It's one of those things that we spent a lot of time together and on the same team, and it was a huge adjustment. But you know, what I think is the most important isn't the basketball side of things. It's always the relationship side of things, and that is good and always will be. What are your thoughts on that?
First of all, that's really kind of him to say. The feelings reciprocated, and how I feel about him. When I first started, what feels like 100 years ago, but when I first started 12 years ago, you know, Coach gave me a chance, and I'm forever indebted to him for that. And Coach taught me so much about, it's I don't know if it's irony, but what he talks about is the relationship part. And one of the things that I learned most from him was the way to treat, take care of people, connect with them individually. So you can't argue with what they've done success-wise. You know, they've been terrific. And we have a great competition on the floor. When we play each other, the crowd's great. But that doesn't, you know, I mean, we want to beat each other's brains in when we play each other, right? I mean, that's why you compete. But when you go through the handshake line, when you're done with it, it's over, you're moving on. And, you know, having those relationships are really important. But I remember, and I'm always grateful for how he's helped and how he's taken care of me. With that, I'll wrap up for today. Friday night will be fun. It'll be a lot of fun to have, you know, our crew travel over there and our guys get to play in that environment. You know, I mean, we've been spoiled. We've been really, really spoiled. And it's not a negative. I don't want it to come across negatively, but it's just an honor to be able to lead the program, to have the environments, to play in the environments that we do. To have the anticipation and the excitement around these games is just a thrill and a really neat honor for me and for our players and our program. And we don't take that lightly. And I think perhaps more so than anything, we take it too much, too literal. And we want to play so well, we want to perform so well, we want to do so well that sometimes that inhibits our ability to do so. So if we can strike that balance going forward Friday night and then throughout the rest of the year, we've got 8 seniors who are trying to keep this thing going as long as they can, and we'll keep fighting for them and doing it. But I certainly appreciate y'all's support and time, and we look forward to seeing you over there on Friday night. Thanks, guys.